Good morning, 9th class students. Today we are going to learn about some applications of osmosis and diffusion process. So here today we know that oceans covers 3/4 of earth with water, but we can't use it. Why? Because it is salty water. So Freddie Mercury and David Bowie, the both persons, scientists, removed salt water, okay, by desalination process. Okay, they removed salt from water by desalination process. This is based upon reverse osmosis. Means here the movement of water molecules take place from higher concentration to their lower concentration through semi-permeable membrane by applying external pressure. Okay, applied pressure. So this is take place and they are making use of drinkable water. Understand? So nowadays people using this method, okay, in areas in which filter salt water through three membranes, okay, because machines are available, reverse osmosis machines. Okay, next, here, what are the importance of osmosis in living organisms in daily life situations? Here roots absorb water by this osmosis process, okay, and between the cells also movement of water molecules take place by this process, and opening and closing of stomata also take place based upon this osmosis process. And movement of water and minerals in plants also take place by osmosis process. And water waste are filtered by the blood. And useful materials are absorbed in us based upon the osmosis process. Next topic is diffusion. The random movement of liquids and gaseous molecules take place from their higher concentration to lower concentration. Okay, here no need of membrane. Understand, this process is called diffusion. So this diffusion, for example, in daily life situations, a scent bottle opened in a corner of your room, so it will spread uniformly after some time. It is based upon the diffusion process. And you might have smelled biryani smells from your neighbor house because it is the process of diffusion. Understand? Okay, so many examples are there like this. Understand? Next, activity 4 is the diffusion with coffee powder. You keep coffee powder ball in a bowl, and you have to take half bowl of water. After some time, it spread uniformly. Understand? Activity 5, diffusion of potassium permanganate crystals in waters. Okay, here pink color the color spread all over the petri dish after some time, based upon the diffusion process. So like this. Activity 6, diffusion of copper sulfate solution. Okay, copper sulfate crystals in water. Okay, and we have to compare with this. Okay, with the above two activities. So some activities will be faster and some activity will be slower. Based upon this, Thomas Graham, a Scottish scientist, he discovered a law that is called Graham's law of diffusion. Here means more soluble substance in a medium diffuse faster than that of less soluble substances. So this is law of diffusion. Okay, so Graham's law of diffusion. So by this chapter is closed. You have to write fair notes. Okay, children. So you have to write all these points and send me. Thank you. Have a nice day.